sorry, very excited to be out here. So excited. Now, we do have some very important speeches to happen this morning before we do start our march. So we are going to go through there. We would love to have all of your attention. So if you are around the back, feel free to come a little bit closer. We're all here for the same reason, and we all love each other. So to kick things off, it gives me great pleasure. Please welcome to the stage is Elder Dawn Daylight to welcome us to country.
Beautiful summer day. I'm one of the elders of the Brisbane Elders, and I belong to our First Nation people, Aboriginal people of this land. You are on the land of the Yuggera people and also of the Turrbal mob north and south of the Brisbane River, Meanjin. What's the name of the river? Can anyone tell me? Maywa. I'd like to welcome everybody, but also pay my respects to our elders and our distinguished guests, Miss Leanne Enoch over here. Yes, the elders are important in our communities, and I'm sure we must have a lot of non-Indigenous peoples from around the world as elders in our LGBT community of people, as I am one of those. So today I can't march. I'm an elder, so we look after elders. Unless you want to push me in a wheelchair. I'm okay, though. And I forgot my walking stick. I have six at home in the cupboard. But I forget where they are. But we do that. Oh, hello. How are you? Thank you. Yes, and I sing also. And we went to a beautiful concert last night in tribute to the Rompi band. Woo! So if anyone likes blackfella music, go to QPAC tonight. Always was. Always will be Aboriginal land. Ooh. Although it's not the same, we can create it again. Oh, 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 oh. Always was, always will be. Say hello to the person next door. Don't be frightened, they don't bite. Though it's not the same, we can create it again. She's waiting, waiting for us to see. Oh, how it's meant to be. Wish I could do that. Will you teach me that? Lay down on our mother earth. Oh, she gave us birth. A white man's facade has been built. Like that one up there. Yeah. We cannot deny the attempt to genocide. Oh, come and see our spirit. Spirits are here in the land, right here where you stand, was Aboriginal land, and it still is, and probably remains of Aboriginal people in the land. Oh, we cannot deny the attempt to genocide. Oh, come and see our spirit run free. see, you wouldn't believe it, under a tree with witchy grubs and snakes. One of the generations of people that was removed. Put your gin on the ground, remember where you're walking on our land, stolen land. We cannot deny, deny, deny the attempt to genocide. Oh, come and see our spirit. I just turned 77, not bad for an old child. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
There are a lot more of you out there. Can you please make some more noise in that for Elder Dawn Daylight, everybody? You mean so, so much to us, so we're really grateful you're here with us this morning. Thank you so much. All right, there's a lot of you. Let's get you a little bit hyped up. First of all, I do see some familiar faces. If this is your first Pride March, give us a yes. Yeah. If you've been here before, give us a yeah. Amazing. So as your MC, by the way, my name's Paul Wheeler. My job is to come up every now and again with some safety stuff because we know that you love to hear that, and that's why we are already here as well. Now, as you can see, there are a lot of people around, and our job is to get everybody to Pride Fair Day nice and safely. So what we will be doing, we actually have two buses arranged. So first of all, we do have a bus over to my left, and that is our First Nations Elders vehicle. We want to make sure you are the first people to arrive at the park for Fair Day. So if you would like to make your way over to the bus during the speeches, and we're ready to get you in. We also have the Brisbane City Council rainbow bus. You can't miss it. It actually has a rainbow on it. So if you are requiring some assistance getting to the park, we do advise you as well to make your way safely over to the bus and arrive in style. Once we have that, we will be starting our parade, and we do have a vehicles first way to go in. So first of all, the Dykes on Bikes will be leading the parade. As always, give it up for the Dykes on Bikes, everybody. Wouldn't be Pride without you. Thank you for everything you do. We also then have the Australia Post vehicle as well. We're making their way through there, and then our buses. So please just make sure once they've made their way over, the rest of us will be marching on over behind them as well. Now, very important that when we get to the other side of the bridge to South Brisbane, please just make sure you are paying attention and listening to any instructions, because there will be some pretty large vehicles turning, and we want to keep you safe. And that's pretty much the safety stuff. Ready, understand, happy to go? Yeah. Amazing. And then when the march starts as well, there are lots of people here. We are all here for the exact same reason. I know it sounds cheesy, but we are a family. So please just make sure you are all looking out for each other as well. There is, of course, no rush. And if you see somebody maybe falling behind, just go and join them as well. So we are all traveling through together. And then I think we're going to be pretty good to go, to go and head on over to the park for Pride Fair Day, which is actually our highest selling of the year ever. So there's going to be a lot of us there. So we're excited for that. That's enough of me. Let's get more entertaining. Let's actually get some more important people than me speaking up. Should we welcome up our next speaker? Fantastic. It gives me great pleasure to welcome to the stage to say a few words the Most Reverend Jeremy Greaves, the Anglican Archbishop of Brisbane.
Thanks, Paul, and thank you to the committee for giving me this opportunity just to say a few words this morning to talk about some of the work that we've been doing in the Anglican Church Southern Queensland over the last 2 years. We are very aware that attitudes and practices within the church have been and continue to be really hurtful and harmful to rainbow people of faith and the broader rainbow community. These things have hurt LGBTIQA+ people and their loved ones. They've undermined the ability of rainbow people of faith to participate fully in the life of the church, and understandably have broken the trust of gender and sexuality diverse people in the church and in the community. 2 years ago, the Anglican Church in southern Queensland resolved to do better. And in 2022, we agreed that an apology might be the first step in a commitment to change. And we began a listening process so that LGBTIQA+ people could safely share their experiences of the church and the impacts of these experiences on them and their families. They're stories that have shaped an apology to the rainbow community by the Anglican Church. And it was overwhelmingly endorsed by representatives from every part of the Anglican Church in southern Queensland. We are incredibly grateful for the honesty, courage, grace, and trust of those who spoke to us, and for their assistance in finding the right words for a meaningful apology. Stories were shared with grace and generosity, and my hope is that the final form of the apology honours those who chose to tell their stories. I hope that in some way the apology begins to attend to the needs of those who have been hurt, and just as importantly expresses our clear intention to do things differently into the future. And I'm really mindful that an apology is just one step on a journey of healing. It doesn't end the process we've started, and the work that we need to do to build some trust and some credibility is to live into the apology in our churches, schools, and other agencies. And this will mean a change to behaviours, language, and policies, among other things. I know that we have much work to do. But it also means recognising and celebrating the fact that there are many LGBTIQA+ people within our church family, in our pews, in our schools, in our care agencies, leading and serving, teaching and ministering among us. And to them I say, we value your presence, we celebrate your gifts, and we respect your lives. Sadly, there are many more people of faith for whom the church has not been a safe place. And we're sorry for the hurt that you've experienced in large and small ways because of people or structures or behaviours in the church. I'm really conscious of the difficulty of offering an apology with appropriate sensitivity and in an appropriate setting, respecting that not everyone will want to hear them now, and understanding that some people won't want to hear them at all. So for those who would like to hear the apology, tomorrow night we will offer the full words of the apology at a service in St John's Cathedral at 6 o'clock, which will also be live streamed on the Cathedral YouTube channel. Everyone's welcome. You can also find the words of the apology and more information at the Cathedral stall in the grounds of Musgrove Park, where you can also meet the Reverend Selena McMahon, our LGBTIQA+ outreach officer. So thank you for giving me this space. Thank you for all you are doing to make the world a better place for all people. Thank you for standing up to be counted. Happy Pride.
Thank you so much again to our Anglican Archbishop, Jeremy Greaves, everybody. So I'm back, so I've got some more stuff for you to know, okay? So I do just want to make this very clear. If you do follow the Brisbane Pride account, you would be aware of this. But when we do get to the park a bit later today, we are actually sharing that space with some people who are there currently. It's an unhoused community. We do just ask you to make sure we are paying them lots of respect when we do enter and leave the site as well. It's very important to do so. Also, speaking of things that are very important, my very good friend Yvette Darf is here, and I'm stealing her lines, which I usually get from her when she's on stage. Please stay sun smart today. It gets very hot in the park. Please make sure you're drinking lots of water. If you bought a hat, wear it. If you haven't bought a hat, maybe buy one from one of our stall holders. We want to make sure you are there for the whole day, okay? All right, it gives me great pleasure to welcome another fantastic speaker up to the stage. Just a reminder, if you are going to be taking one of our two buses over to the park, we do ask you to maybe start considering making your way over there now. But are you ready for another speaker? Yes, you are. It gives me great pleasure to welcome to the stage Queensland Premier Stephen Miles.
Thanks so much. Good morning, everyone. Can I also acknowledge the traditional owners of the land we're gathered on here today and pay my respects to them and their elders and thank Auntie Dawn for that beautiful, rousing welcome to country. Wasn't it amazing? I want to acknowledge Archbishop Jeremy, that statement and the sentiment behind it is pretty special, and so thank you for sharing it with us this morning. Can I thank James and everyone from the Pride Committee for all the work you do all year, putting on fantastic events like this one, and for inviting me along to speak today. There are a bunch of my team here, a whole heap of our ministers and MPs. They are all really strong allies of our LGBTQIA+ community. And together we've worked with you on so many issues. It's dangerous. It's always dangerous to single out one of your colleagues, but we are in her electorate. And so I want to shout out to Grace Grace. There is no stauncher ally. You have no stauncher ally anywhere in politics than Grace Grace, and we want to keep her. So if you live in McConnell, please do support Grace. But with that team and working with you, we have delivered so many reforms. We reintroduced civil partnerships, which was an important stage on the way to marriage equality. We equalised the age of consent, long overdue. We removed the defence of gay panic. We banned gay conversion therapy. We made historic reforms to our state's Births, Deaths and Marriages Act to support our trans and gender diverse community. But we know there is still so much more to do to properly eliminate discrimination in our state. That's why this year we released our first ever Pride in Our Communities strategy, and we backed it with a $200,000 investment in regional Pride events, as well as a $1 million investment into a, for the first time, LGBTQIA alliance. And today, here at Pride, I'm really proud to announce that if I'm elected in October, I will double funding to Pride, to this event, to regional Pride events, and to that alliance. I'm also really proud to stand here before you all and say that I'm the first Premier who will march in the Pride march today alongside all of you. Because today we remember the injustices of the past, we celebrate the progress that we have made, and we recommit to each other to keep fighting for equality. Because while the arc of our state's future does tend to point towards progress, progress is not inevitable. We can go backwards. We know there are places going backwards right now. We know there are powerful forces who would take us backwards. In fact, just last week in Parliament, we had to have a debate about whether it should be illegal to discriminate on the basis of sexual identity or of historic homosexual offences just last week. It is incumbent on us to stop them, to ensure that our state's future does point towards progress, does point towards equality. To make sure our state's future does point towards love and celebrating love and diversity. Thank you all so much for coming out today. I can't wait till the march and having some fun at the festival as well. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Premier. It does mean so much to us that you are here and you'll be marching with us too. And I do approve, the shoes do look comfortable but also cool. So you are going to be absolutely great. All right, everybody, are we feeling H-O-T-T-O-G-O to march? Amazing. So once again, the vehicles will be leading the march. You can probably hear, but the dykes on bikes are getting ready to lead us. When it comes to those of us that are marching by foot, we will, of course, ask for our First Nations leaders to lead us all, followed by everybody else. Now, I do want to say that if you did come to this march by yourself, you are very much not alone. We are all here together, so please make sure you are chatting and enjoying.
Thank you. grab. Always will be. This is not.